Hey guys, thanks for tuning into my Fab 5 NFL selections for week 13. I'm Lee Martin, and I hope you checked in last week when I went 4-1 against the spread, including another Platinum Play winner with the Cleveland Browns. We are now 5-2 on the season with our Platinum Plays, and I've got another one this week. But before anything, be sure to give us a like and subscribe to our channel for more premium picks and up-to-date betting info. Let's get to it as we head over to Carolina, where we see the Panthers as 10-point home favorites over the visiting Redskins. Washington won a big game last week when they defeated the Lions 19-16. But let's face it, when you've only had two victories over your first 11 games, every win is big. But all those good vibes in DC will come to a screeching halt this weekend when the Panthers dismantle the Skins and cover the number. While Dwayne Haskins was busy taking selfies with the fans last week and missing the final snap of the game, the Panthers were in the midst of losing a 34-31 heartbreaker to the Saints as 10-point road dogs. It was a gritty effort from Carolina and their quarterback Kyle Allen. He should be able to go to work on a weak Washington defense. His top target, DJ Moore, is having a huge season and will pad his stats this week, while Christian McCaffrey should have no problem trampling the 28th ranked run stop unit in the league. The Redskins are averaging 13.1 points per game, dead last in the league, and Carolina should easily cover the number here. Back the Cats minus 10 at Bookmaker. Let's move on to our second pick of the week, where we'll take the plunge on the 49ers over the Ravens in the biggest game, which may even be a Super Bowl preview. The line on this game has jumped from Baltimore minus 4.5 to where it currently stands at minus 6. That's nothing but good news for dog lovers, because the public will be betting Baltimore early and often, and this line could spike even higher. But for purposes, we'll take San Francisco plus 6 and watch their defense contain Lamar Jackson, something no one else has been able to do this season. I am high on the Niners for several reasons, and one of them is that they're one of the best teams in the league with a 10-1 record and will be facing a Baltimore team that is due for a letdown after crushing the Rams last week. Let's also factor in that the Ravens lost their starting center last week when Matt Skura went out with a knee injury. That should allow more pressure from the Niners' defensive front and keep this one close. Bet the 49ers plus 6 at 5 dimes because you probably won't see them as underdogs again this season. Let's stay in the early afternoon games on Sunday with our third pick of the week as we look for the Indianapolis Colts to take on the Tennessee Titans. Ryan Tannehill is the flavor of the month in Tennessee after he looked sharp against the Jaguars last week in throwing two touchdown passes and rushing for two more. Derrick Henry was also a monster in that game, with 159 yards rushing and a pair of touchdowns of his own. However, the Jags' run defense is atrocious, and Tannehill was able to pass because Jacksonville was so busy trying to stop the run. This time will be different, because the Colts' run defense is one of the best in the league, which means Tannehill will be forced to pass. We've seen Tannehill over the long term, and the fact is, he's a good backup, but not a viable starter. On the other side of the ball, the Tennessee secondary will get exploited without Malcolm Butler, because Colts quarterback Jacoby Brissett will be able to elude every good Titans pass rush and hit his targets against his woeful secondary. Let's look for Indy to get a solid win against a divisional rival. Bet the Colts minus 2.5 at BetOnline. Our fourth pick of the week brings us to a Sunday night matchup in Houston between the Patriots and the Texans. We're going to bet with the public in this game and lay the points on the road with New England. Every now and again, it's hip to be square, especially when you're making money, and that's what we'll do in this game. The Patriots' offense is stumbling, but that defense is world class. And I can't see Houston generating any offense with a magnificent pass defense capable of shutting down the Deshaun Watson to DeAndre Hopkins connection. Of course, the Pats' D isn't quite as potent against the run. But I'm not worrying about Carlos Hyde winning this game on the ground for the Texans. Lastly, expect Tom Brady to have a much better time of it than he did last week in a rain-soaked victory over the Cowboys. This one will be played indoors, and the chances are that Brady will have Mohamed Sanu and or Philip Dorsett back in action. New England got their starting blindside tackle back last week, and it was an immediate upgrade in protection. Isaiah Wynn will be even better this week, after shaking off the rush after being out of the season with a toe injury. His presence bodes well, and not just for pass protection, but for the New England rushing attack as well. We find that 5 dimes is one of the few books giving us the Pats at minus 3 versus 3.5 at most of the others, and we'll take it. Bet the Pats -3 at 5 dimes. Here we go for our fifth and final Sunday selection, known as the Platinum Play of the Week. It is our best bet on the board, and for that we lock onto the Kansas City Chiefs as they prepare to punish the Oakland Raiders, just like they did back in September when these teams met in Oakland. KC was without Tyreek Hill in that game, and they still easily covered the number as 7-point road chalk in a 28-10 victory. On Sunday, they will not only be at Arrowhead, but will have a healthy Hill in uniform, allowing Patrick Mahomes to carve up the Raiders' secondary all afternoon long. While you could make a case that Oakland's ground attack led by Josh Jacobs will have its way against the Chiefs, the problem is that KC will be up early, which will force Oakland to pass. That's a track meet the Raiders can't possibly win. Bet the Chiefs -10 at Bookmaker and make it a winning week. Well, that's it for me in week 13 of the NFL season, and thanks very much for watching. I invite all of you to click on over to the SBR Picks page, where you can see my Fab 5 write-up as well as an excellent analysis by all of our cappers at SBR. Make sure to give us a like and subscribe to our channel for more premium picks and up-to-date betting info. Have a great weekend, and always, I'm Lee Martin, and may all your wagers be winners.